Day 2 of the Wyoming BDR started out for us just outside of Centennial at Libby Campground. After a nice and restful night of sleep, we headed out towards the Snowy Mountain Range, which offered some beautiful views of snow-capped peaks and Blue Mountain lakes. After enjoying the Wyoming alpine environment, we rode a short section of highway to the optional deep water crossing section, which turned out wasn't so deep after all. After the creek crossing, we rode some rocky trails until we rejoined the main route. Before continuing to Elk Mountain, we decided to take the optional side trip up Kennedy Peak, which offered great views of the Snowy Range down to the distant desert towards which we were heading. The trails from Kennedy Peak to Elk Mountain started as a windy gravel road through a forest environment and later opened up to a fast dirt road surrounded by lush ranches. We were hoping to grab some food in Elk Mountain, but everything was closed, so we headed to a gas station not far away, just across from I-80. Rather than ending our day with the end of Section 2, we decided to start Section 3 and see how far we would make it. Once we crossed I-80, the desert section started, which was a really fun and beautiful section that offered some great views of a windmill farm in the distance. From there, a short highway section took us into the tiny town of Medicine Bow. Here we started a long highway section towards the Shirley Mountains. Once we turned off the highway, we took a mix of dirt and rocky roads up the Shirley Mountains, where we ultimately made camp at the bone and carcass littered overlook. Our group had four riders in total. We had Bradley on his Husky 901 Norton, Joe on his Husqvarna 701, Matt on his KTM 890R, and myself on another Husqvarna 701 Enduro. The Snowy Range of Wyoming was a really unique section. It was high altitude, beautiful lush green environment, and snow-capped mountains. This area really reminded us of Colorado, in particular around the San Juan Mountains, just outside of Ouray. This section was also the last time until Section 7 that we saw comfortable and cool temperatures. Once we arrived at the deep water crossing, we went off our bike and took a look. Turned out it wasn't so deep. The rocks were a little slippery, and the biggest challenge would be to try not getting our front tires caught between those big bricks. We all made it across without any issues in the end. By the time we arrived in Elk Mountain, all of us were really hungry and were looking forward to sitting down, taking a break, and having some good food. Unfortunately, we found that the only place to eat and the only store in town were closed. So we drove on a couple of miles to a gas station just across of I-80 and had some snacks and water.
Thank you. Last stop for probably today. Everybody, are you good? Are you good? Do you need anything?
Good.
All right. We got some highway in front of us.
By the time we arrived at the Shirley Mountain Overlook, all of us were getting pretty tired and fatigued. Going on to Alcova would have been another 3 to 4 hours, so we decided to make camp here instead, which turned out to be the right decision. We had a beautiful campfire with amazing views and a restful night.